Father, we thank you. We worship you this morning. We thank you that this is the day that you've made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. We honor you, King of Glory. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, we shall magnify your name. We thank you, Lord of Glory, that you are our God, our Maker, our King. Thank you, Lord of Glory, that you have blessed us with all blessings, spiritual blessings in the heavenly places. We thank you that you're God with us, God for us, and God in us. We worship you this morning. Thank you, Holy Spirit of the living God. We welcome you, Lord. We welcome you into this place. We welcome you in our midst this morning. Let the Spirit of the living God move so strongly in our midst and in our life. May we experience you like never before, God. We thank you, Holy Spirit of the living God. Debra sonta le makabarosa. Mandula gaseke badula bagede basoy. Debra masunda lebrege badula bagada. Good morning, Sister Charity. Blessing, blessing. Good to see you this morning. Trust you're well this morning. Glory to God. Thank you for being here this morning. Honor God for you always. Such a blessing to be connected with you. Well, family, we welcome you. For those of you that are just coming in, it's yet another day. We're ready to bless the name of the Lord and lift up the name of God as we prepare to go out this morning. Hallelujah. We'll just take a few more minutes as we wait for the family to come in, our regulars to fill up the room. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Mandala bagasoto lobogoria de bagada bagaba. Sandra, good morning. Good morning or good evening? Is it evening or it should be good evening to you? Trust that you're well. Trust that the Lord has kept you. Good to see you. Thank you for being here this morning. Amen. Glory to God. Father, we thank you for today. Masota labukoto lobosa. Lepra kasata bababa sonda legebre. Mambriga bagadula bagasotada. Le bagasoto lobogo dibiriada bagada bagat. Let the presence of God go forth with us from this day, Lord. We pray like Moses said, that if your presence does not go with us, do not send us from here. We ask for your presence. We ask for your glory. We ask for your power. We ask, Jehovah, that we will see you like never before in these days and in these seasons of our life. In the name of Jesus, glory to God. What a blessing, what a blessing. Hallelujah, glory to God. Rabrega sota labraga. Family, we'll just take maybe one or two more minutes and then we'll get going, so that those of you that are preparing to go to work this morning or to rest, like Sandra, I believe it's time for you guys to, because of the time difference, it's time for you guys to rest. We want to just believe God this morning again for his blessing and for his favor. But we thank God for all of you that are here. Zodwa is here. Glory to God. Good morning, Zodwa. Amen. Good to see you online, Zodwa. Trust that you're well. It's always a blessing to be connected to you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Father, we thank you. We give him all the glory. 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 We honor him because he has been so, so good to us. He has been so, so good to us. This morning, you need to be reminded of the faithfulness of God in your life and how God has been good to you. The scripture says to us, it is not to him that willeth or him that runneth, but unto God that sheweth mercy. It is because of the mercies of God that are renewed every morning. That is why we are not consumed. People who have everything to keep themselves safe, to keep themselves healthy, some of them are not here today. Not because of anything, but we can say that you are here today because of the mercies of God. God's mercies have kept us and sustained us unto this very day. And so we bless the name of the Lord this morning. We honor God even as we rise up unto this day, even as we wake up into a new day. We declare that the Lord God, who has been merciful to us, let his name be praised, let his name be exalted. We worship him and we thank him. You can turn that place that you're in right now into a moment of just appreciating of God, thanking him for this new day that we have entered into in the name of Jesus Christ, and bless his name for his faithfulness over your life. Glory, glory, glory to God. What a blessing to see you all. Pastor Kuzi, good morning to you. We welcome you. We honor God for you this morning. Thank you for being here. I trust that your first day back at work was great. Amen. We honor God for every one of you in the name of Jesus Christ. Well, family, we're going to get going right now so that we can be able to allow you to go and prepare for those of you that have to get to work. But before we go further, we want to read two scriptures and pray them in our life right now. Isaiah chapter number 65 and verse number 23, it says, they will not labor in vain, nor will they bear children doomed for misfortune, for they will be a people blessed by the Lord, they and their descendants with them. I want you to write that down if you're writing, so that you can have that as a prayer point, that you will not labor in vain. Then the word of God says to the righteous, and again in the word of God in Isaiah, say, tell the righteous, it shall be well with them, and they shall eat the fruit of their deeds. The fruits of their deed, that which you're doing, your efforts shall not be in vain. Your efforts in this season, in this year, shall not be in vain. Anything that wants to render your efforts it to be in vain, to be unproductive, not to bear fruit, is not of God. And we want to come against it this morning in the name of Jesus, even as we start. The first thing we are going to do, we lift up the name of the Lord in this day and declare that the blessing of the Lord be with us in this day. Shall we pray and declare this blessing? Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you that this is the day that you have made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. We thank you, King of Glory, because of your mercies that are renewed every morning. That is why we are not consumed. As we have risen into this day, O God, we thank you that the blessing that you have destined for us in this day shall come upon us in the name of Jesus Christ. We speak over this day that the path is cleared for us to be fruitful, to be effective, that our labor will not be in vain, that anything and everything that wants to affect our labor, our effort to bring the results that we desire to see in our life, let it be consumed and be destroyed by the power of the Almighty. As your word has declared to us, to tell the righteous that it shall be well with them, and that they shall eat the fruit of their deeds, of their doing. This year, our efforts shall bear much fruit in the name of Jesus Christ. We thank you and we glorify you in the name of Jesus. Amen. May that be your declaration. May that be that which you're speaking in this season. Well, saints of God, what a blessing again to be connected with you this morning. Eunice and I are grateful to God that you're here this morning, and it is a joy for us to be able to minister to you in this hour as you're getting ready to go to work. We began yesterday, and I'll try and pick from yesterday as we build on today so that we can be able to gain something and run with. Something has to give this particular month. Something has to give for you to be able to experience what God's word is saying and what God has promised us in his word. I say that the scriptures are not just meant to be read and for us to quote them. It is meant to be lived and for us to be able to experience what God's word is saying in our time. Just like the people
who in their time when the scriptures were applicable, it literally in their time as they applied the principles, the truth that are written in the Bible, even us in our time can take these very words and apply them in our life and get the same result, because God is not a respecter of any person. The Bible says to us that in the book of Acts of the Apostles, God is not a respecter of any person. He that feareth the Lord and worketh after righteousness is accepted by God. So irregardless of your background, your skin color, whatever it is about you, God is not a respecter of persons. God is not a respecter of us. He will bless you just as he has blessed somebody else in the United States of America. He will bless you just as he has blessed somebody else in Europe. He is not a God who is dealing with us in levels of preference that I prefer this one over the other one. If we do the right thing, God's blessing will be manifest over our life. And so we read about Daniel, how Daniel understood by the books that the time for them to be in captivity was 70 years, and the 70 years were over, but yet they were in captivity. We use that scripture to bring out the truth that I was bringing out, that things don't just happen, things are caused to happen. Things don't just happen. They are caused to happen. And we read from the word of God in Galatians that says that God cannot be mocked, for whatsoever a man soweth, that also shall he reap. The literal translation of that verse says there can never be an effect without a cause. Things are caused to happen. Things are caused to happen. So Daniel understood that the time for being in captivity was over, but they were still in captivity. So he had to do something that would cause them to be able to experience what the word of God is saying. And so that is why we got into the place where we are reading the word of God that says to us that we don't wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, evil powers in the unseen world. And we spoke about the realm of the intangible realm, the spirit realm, where the things that are there influence the things that are happening here in the natural world. And if we can learn to engage ourselves by prayer and applying biblical principles, then we will be able to experience what God's word is saying. There is no curse that is stronger than the word of God. The blessing is stronger than any curse. There is nothing in your bloodline right now that when you will begin to engage in the word of God that can be able to stand. There is nothing that can be able to hinder you from seeing what God's word is saying if we will continue in the word of God. Why do I say that? I'll read for you a scripture right now and give you some more scriptures so that you can be able to get this. The Bible says to us in the book of James chapter number 1 and verse number 25, but if you look carefully into the perfect law that sets you free, the perfect law that sets you free, which is the word of God, and if you do what it says and do not forget what you have had, then God will bless you for doing it. If we look into the perfect law, which is the word of God, and do that which is written there and not forget it, then God will bless us. In the word of God, again, we are told in the book of Joshua chapter number 1 and verse number 8, Joshua is told, this book of the law shall not depart from your mouth. You shall meditate on it day and night, so that you may be careful to do according to all that is written therein. So then you will make your ways prosperous, and then you will have a good success. You will have a good success. Success don't happen by accident. It takes knowledge, and it takes being conscious and being committed to what you want to experience. And so as a child of God, the first avenue for you to be able to gain a success, it is through the word of God, knowing the principles that God has provided in his word to guarantee the success that you want to see in any area of your life. Two people in the Bible that governed themselves with the word of God and sought the Lord, and God established them, that we want to look at. The first one is found in 2 Chronicles chapter number 27 and verse number 6. It talks about Jotham. It says, Jotham became mighty because he prepared his ways before the Lord. He prepared his ways before the Lord and God made him mighty. Other version says, God made him to succeed. He prepared his ways in the presence of them. In other words, he sought the Lord. Today, me and you can seek God by going into his word to find out what is written about us regarding our economy, regarding our families, regarding our business, regarding our nations, our children, in this time that we are in. And if we seek him, he will be able to establish us and cause us to experience what he wants us to experience. The second character is in 2 Chronicles chapter number 26. Verse number 3, it talks of Uzziah. It says, Uzziah, listen to this. This is the most interesting one that I liked. Uzziah was 16 years, a teenager, pushed into the place of being a king. A 16, can you imagine that? A 16-year-old taking over the responsibility of running an entire nation. A 16 years. Look at it in our time. Imagine if we're using a system of kingdoms and the king passes on and the next in line is 16 years of age. He took over at the age. That's a teenager. That's a teenager. That's still somebody who still needs to be playing with PlayStations in our time. But he took over a great responsibility of leading a nation. And this is what the Bible says. Uzziah was 16 years old when he became king. And he reigned in Jerusalem for 52 years. 52 years. That means the entire time that he was there, in total, by the time he was getting out of the kingship, it was about 68 years. He took over at 16. He was there for 52 years. That gives him 68 years. He was reigning there. His mother's name was Jecolyam. She was from Jerusalem. Then the Bible says, and he did what was right in the eyes of the Lord, according to all that his father Amasa had done. Uzziah, listen to what the Bible says. Uzziah sought God during the days of Zechariah, who taught him the fear of God. And as long as the king sought guidance from God, God made him to succeed. As long as he sought guidance from the Lord, God made him to succeed. What enabled him to establish a kingdom that was prosperous, that was successful, is the premise upon which he was being governed. He was being governed by God. He was being governed by the principles of God's word. You too today and me can govern our life through the principles, the timeless principles of God's word, and see the success that God has intended for us. The economies of the world are looking different right now, but God is not moved by the economy. The economy of heaven is superior than this economy. If we will begin to apply God's word in our life today, we will see what these people say. So, why am I saying that? Psalms chapter 119 and verse number 89, scripture says to us this, O Lord, your word is settled in heaven forever. The word of God is settled in heaven forever. God's word cannot change. God cannot change his word now. It is already established in heaven. When you begin to apply the word of God, you begin to experience what God's word is saying. Jesus said to us in the book of John chapter number 8, and verse number 32, that you shall know the truth and the truth will set you free. You will know the truth and the truth will set you free. Daniel knew the truth when he got into the word of God. He discovered that God has not intended for us to live like this. Even though it was said that we will be in bondage, God has promised us prosperity. God has promised us wealth. God has promised us victory. And the moment Daniel discovered that truth in the word of God, he began to apply it in his life. He began to engage it, that principle, until he got got the result that he wanted to see. My brothers and sisters, this morning we need to remind ourselves that if we are going to have the life that we want to see in these times that we are in, we have to engage the principles of God's word aggressively in this time. We have to get into the word of God and find everything that is written about us and begin to present it before God, irregardless of what we are seeing. David said, I come in the volume of books it is written of I. What have we discovered that is written about us in the word of God? Therein is where we can find victory. Hear this. Anything that is not established on depth is prone to be removed. Anything that is not established on depth is prone to be removed. By depth, I'm not referring to talking deep. By depth, I am talking about grounded, going deep down and finding something that it stands on. Success that is not based on something that can be passed on to somebody else cannot last. And as a child of God, your only avenue that you can be able to stay grounded is by going into the word of God and settling on those principles as the truth that can be able to bring you out. Jesus said in the word of God in John chapter 17 and verse number 17, thy word is truth. You build with the word of God because that is the truth that can be able to bring liberation in our life and bring the promises that God has said in his word. A research is done about trees. I'll say this before we close and pray. A research is done about certain trees that survive in regardless of the season of that they are in, regardless of the season where they're planted. A research is done to find out why do some trees wither during winter or during time when there is no water, yet other trees in the same region still flourish and remain green. And when the research was concluded, they discovered that some trees have the ability to dig their roots deep down and find the right source, the right place where water comes from. And therein they establish themselves. Once they've established their roots in that place, irregardless of what is happening in the natural sphere, they remain fruitful, they remain budding, because the roots have gone deep down into the source of water, and therein is where their life is grounded and coming from. Also, as children of God, our roots must be in the word of God. Our roots must be established in God's word. That is where our true victory and success will come from, irregardless of what is happening in the natural sphere. My brothers and sisters, hold on to what the promises of God are saying, because therein is life. Therein there is prosperity for your business, for your family, for yourself as an individual. Irregardless of what news you had, you remain established in the promises of God's word. And the moment you discover a truth in God's word, you build your life with it. It becomes your confession. It becomes that which you believe to see in your life. It becomes what you're declaring every day, so that you can be able to walk in it in the name of Jesus Christ. I'll read one scripture before again we close with a word of prayer. We have about 3-4 minutes to go. I'll read for you one scripture, slightly long, but I want you to see it and be able to read it for yourself at your own time. Psalm 19, from verse number 7 to verse number 11, it says this: the law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul. The testimony of the Lord is sure, making wise the simple. The statutes of the Lord are right, rejoicing the heart. The commandments of the Lord are pure, enlightening the eye. The fear of the Lord is clean, enduring forever. The judgment of the Lord are true and righteous altogether. More to be desired are they than gold. Yea, much than fine gold. Sweeter also than honey and honeycomb. Verse number 11. Moreover, by them your servant is warned, and in keeping them there is great reward. Now that is David's testimony about the word of God and its effect in his life, that by observing them, he is guided by it, and there is great reward for observing the word of God. Child of God, in the seasons that we are in, our only ticket to victory is believing God for what he has said. Look at Isaiah. He's in a place where he wants to move to a place that looks greener on the other side. He wants to move into a land that it looks like there is things happening, because where he is, there's been famine for a prolonged season. God says to him, stay in this land and do what I'm telling you. I'm paraphrasing, and I will bless you. He listens to God, applies what God is telling him, and he sees the victory in a place of famine. There is no famine that can hinder the word of God. There is no famine. The scripture said the word of God is not bound. There is no situation that we are dealing with right now that is stronger than the word of God. There is no economic crisis that is greater than the word of God. This word is stronger. This word is powerful, and it is capable of producing what God's word is saying in our life. My brothers and sisters, as you're stepping out this morning into your workplace, into your business, into whatever you're doing, exalt the word of God today and declare that that which God is saying is what I will believe to see in my life, in my family, in my company, in my nation. Our nation is not going down. We refute every narrative that is saying that our nations and economies are going down. We're declaring right now there is going to be a revival in economy. There's going to be a revival in companies. God is going to make a way for us in the name of Jesus Christ. And if that is our testimony, we want to believe it. And we want to pray, because we declare that we are raising our expectation. And what we are expecting, we begin to declare it as we find it in the word of God. Something has to give in this very month for you. The promises of God over your life must begin to manifest regardless of what we are seeing. Can we pray and believe God right now in the name of Jesus? Father, we thank you for your word has gone forth. Thank you that you sent forth your word and it delivered and healed them. This morning, as we have received the incorruptible word of God that is able to save our soul, we declare right now there is no circumstance in life that we are dealing with, that we are faced with, that cannot be solved by the power that is in the name of Jesus Christ. And as we release the word of over every situation that any one of us may be facing, we declare, let it be defeated. Let sickness be healed. Let lack be destroyed. Let lack of opportunities be destroyed. We release right now favor upon every child of God as they step out into their workplaces. We call forth their wealth. We call forth every opportunity that they need. We speak wisdom over them, that as they go out in the marketplace, Lord, you'll make them to shine. You will cause them, Lord of glory, to operate in a new dimension. We speak of our nations right now, prosperity, revival in the economy. We declare right now that our economies are beginning to grow again in the name of Jesus Christ. We speak that this year, Lord of glory, we shall harvest more than ever before, because your word is true, in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we declare divine protection over everyone that is going out this morning. Wherever they go, let your protection be upon them in the name of Jesus Christ. We honor you and we glorify you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. The Lord bless you as you step out this morning, saints of God. We wish and pray for you that the glory of God manifest over you in the marketplace for our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Jesus said, occupy until I come. It's your time to shine. It's your time to see the favor of God. We look forward again to connect with you tomorrow, in the same time. Let the hand of God be strong over your life. Shalom, peace.